Jonathan Moore. This is the introduction of his introduction. Officially promoted to the post of senior instructor early this year, Jonathan is faced with a host of new challenges at his workplace, which does give him a lot of stress. Fortunately, he doesn't have to look far to blow steam, as the entertainment is given for free by his students, which allows him to exercise his lungs and muscles while laughing at his students' antics and bloopers once they're all gone home. Comes his speech title, A Normal Day at LEA. A Normal Day at LEA, I was completely confused. This is Jonathan Moore.
One fine day at combat kickboxing, three friends were having a conversation, which one of them was yours truly. My friend Wei Leong came over here and put his arm around my shoulder. Hey dude, listen up man! In his ever yo man tone. Hey, you know what? Being a teacher is very easy, you know, Jonathan. You studied only for 4 years, and you're earning more than me. I'm an engineer, I have to slog day by day, and I have to repair lifts. Mm-hmm, said I. And another of my friend, my kickboxing buddy, Yos, came up to me and said, Jonathan, do you know what? I just finished my TESOL course in 5 weeks, and I want to be an English teacher here in Malaysia. Do you know of any job openings? I heard it's very easy to make money. Right, sit up. Okay guys, let me tell you what. I'm gonna tell you a little story about a normal day at my workplace. And then, I shall let you decide whether being an English teacher is such an easy job. I would like to tell you guys about what happened yesterday. You know, Yos, William, Daniel, there you are. He just joined the conversation. Being an English teacher, officially promoted to senior instructor, I have to deal with a lot of things. I have to be a psychologist, I have to be a counselor, I have to be a teacher, I have to be a friend, I have to be a manager. Many, many hats at once. The next thing, I'll just like to tell you about what happened in my class. A typical day. One fine day, I was teaching. I had to sub a class of starter students. Level 1, whose students are here for their first month in Malaysia and they do not know a single word of English. Level 1. Topic, eating at the restaurant. Role play. I got my students to role play and to practice their vocabulary and how to order food in a restaurant here in Malaysia. So I was playing the role of the waiter while they have to order food from me. So one day, one of the ladies walked up to me and said, Mr. Jonathan, I would like to order a booger. Wait, Aidana, do you mean a burger? Yes, teacher, a booger. You know, fish booger, chicken booger, egg booger. I see. Aidana? Alright. You mean a burger? Yes, teacher. Booger, teacher. Booger! Okay, stop. Little bit of vocabulary section, class. First of all, a burger is something you order at McDonald's, which you eat. You know, the fish, the chicken, and the vegetables, you put it together with 2 pieces of bread. Class, a booger is... Do you still want to eat my booger, Aidana? That is a booger, teacher?
Yes.
No, teacher! No! I don't want to eat your boogers! Yes, so please remember, class, lesson of the day, make sure you pronounce your words correctly. If not, people will think you want something else. lesson. Back to the lesson. Next, order food. Next student walking up to me and to order food. Well, that's only one of my classes, you know, Yos and Wei Leong. The second class I had in that on the same day, it was a group of students again, this time also starter, level 2, and they know a little bit more of English. So I was teaching them about relationships. I was talking to them about how to actually handle yourself and how to speak to people on the street or at a shopping mall when you want to buy something. Out of a sudden, my student asked me, "Mr. Jonathan, can I ask you a question?" "Yes, Reza." "Why do Musa don't like me?" "Musa? You mean as an Arabic for beautiful girls, Reza?" "Yes, teacher. Why Malaysian girls not friendly with me?" "That's a very good question. Do you remember what you did yesterday, Reza?" "Well, teacher, I only snuck up, I only walked slowly to the students, to Anna's table and smell her spectacles." "Reza, do you do this in your country?" "No, teacher, in my country it is haram." Okay, so Reza, if you are a girl, would you like a man smelling your spectacles?" "No, teacher." "Then why would you do that to a girl?" "Well, teacher, she smelled nice." Right. So maybe that's why girls don't like you, Reza. "But in my country, men and women separate. I want to talk to girls." Okay. So, I was at a loss for words. So back to the situation at the gym. Wei Leong, Yos, these are the situations I face on a normal day in my classroom on a daily basis if I'm very unlucky, or if I'm very lucky, 3 times a week. There's still a lot more stories which I can tell you, but this is what it takes to be an English teacher, guys. You have to be very, very, very patient with my students, especially when they come from a foreign country and they do not mean to offend you. They just do not have the language, and some of them are socially inept in a foreign culture. So my question to you two jokers over here, do you still want to be an English teacher? Back to you.
Dramatic talk by Jonathan Moore over here. I have his evaluator waiting over there. Distinguished Toastmaster So Fong Wai, please welcome. So Fong Wai.
Thank you, General Evaluator. A normal day at LEA. So I'm going to evaluate your speech based on LEA. I will start from L, which is the learning I got from this speech. Now, I thought a good speaker that presented this speech has this character, good pauses. You have good pauses. Your vocal is clear and with a lot of energy. You set the scene and you share with us your personal experience. So this is the requirement from the manual. E, expectation. Since you are doing an advanced speech, so the audience will have more expectation from you, I'm going to do a few suggestions to enhance your speech. First of all, I look at your vocal and your delivery is actually okay, except the movement. Some movements are a little bit distracting. instruct, what can enhance your practice? Because this speech is for you to practice the dramatic talk. What can enhance is to use one story instead of a small little example. Because for 5 to 7 minutes, if you use one story to practice the dramatic talk, you can actually use a lot of your vocal, your gestures, body language, movements to make it more dramatic. I thought that could be enhanced because you have it, but you just didn't do it in one story. Last but not least, the audience. When you do a dramatic talk, whether you have managed to connect to the audience, yes, I will say you have managed to connect to the audience. Does the audience entertain? They enjoy your speech. Yes, I can see from their faces, they enjoy it, they follow throughout. That is very, very good. Especially the example of burger. Right? So we all remember that very well. Now, if you could have, just make sure you use one event itself to go through it, I thought the whole practice for you will be totally different. But overall, you have did well, you have entertained us, I enjoy your speech, and I will say you have all the characteristics of doing this speech well. I look forward for your next entertaining speech. Thank you.